In this video, I want to go through the I/O settings in Pro Tools. So we head to Setup, I/O. And from the last videos, your hardware device or your sound card will be visible here. And we can see that I have got 24 ins and 24 outs. Your device might be slightly different. It might be 2 in, 2 out, 8 in, 8 out, 16 in, 16 out. But here we can actually control those inputs. If you've got a device that allows for analog inputs like microphones and instruments, they'll be known as analog. Or you might have digital like ADAT or other MADI converters. They'll be visible along here as well. But for now, this is the in and out. And we can see on the output here, the little speaker defines which is our main out. So that's your inputs, that's your outputs. Now, if you do make changes to these, I would suggest that you export your settings and save them somewhere. Oh yeah, settings. In your I/O settings folder, and then you can import them. If you have any problems, or if you reinstall Pro Tools, or you have to trash your preferences, you can re-import your I/O settings. You can also restore from a session. So if there's a different I/O that you remember you had in a certain session, you can restore from that. You can feel free to double click these to rename them. So this might be, and that is speakers and the inputs. So we might say that this is microphone mic 2. And you can go through and rename these, or you can add new paths. So we can create new paths and we can assign them to things. So we could say, call this path mic, create that path, and I can assign that to a channel on the hardware itself. To delete a path, we can delete down here, and to default, that'll take us back to the default settings. We can see the default format is stereo. We can change that to mono or other channel sizes. And the path order is LCR, RC, depending on what you're working. If you're working in podcasting or just stereo mixing for TV, this one's fine, LCR. Output settings. Along here, we've got our default monitor path. So when we create a new track or a new aux, as we can see here, they're all sent to monitors. We can name that there. Our audition path. So this would be if we are in the workspace, :, that would be when we play things up here. When we play these files up here, this is the audition path. Let's go back to I/O. Fold down, don't need to worry unless you're doing 5.1, which I sincerely doubt. Default meter path, you can choose which is your default meters. So you could have it just look at the channels that you're outputting. And this is the after fader and pre fader level. Again, you can choose to have that send somewhere else, but we do not want to do that. So that is your inputs and outputs related to your audio interface, whatever that may be.